and I'm coming from the Mystic Aquarium, and today I have two friends with me, and we are going to talk about seals and sea lions. So at Mystic Aquarium, we have a couple different types of seals and sea lions. We have harbor seals, spotted seals, northern fur seals, California sea lions, and stellar sea lions. They're all beautiful creatures, and they all have their own individual characteristics. But let's start off today with talking a little bit about what makes a sea lion or seal that particular animal. First of all, they are mammals, just like us. Can you tell me, one of you or both of you, what makes a mammal a mammal?
Because they have fur and they're warm-blooded.
They have fur, they're warm-blooded. Anything else? What runs down your back? Your
spine.
Your spine, so they have a backbone. And tell me, when they have babies, how do they have babies?
They have it in their stomach.
They have live birth, is that what you're telling me?
Yeah.
Yeah? And how do they feed those babies?
Milk.
They give them milk. They're gonna nurse them. And what do they use to breathe with?
Lungs.
Good job. They have lungs, they don't have gills like fish do. So in order to be a marine mammal, there's one characteristic that we add into that, and that's that streamlined torpedo-shaped body that lets them be able to glide through the water very quickly with little resistance.
So they can escape from sharks by trying to bite them.
Oh, exactly. They have to be able to get away from the predators, yep.
Yeah.
So up here, I have a seal and a sea lion. Can they be the same color?
No, they're
usually browns and grays and blacks and whites. But yeah, they do have a lot of similarities in color. But they have some very specific characteristics that separate these two. So first of all, my friend number one, can you tell me one thing that is different between my seal and my sea lion?
The seal has shorter flippers, and the sea lion has the longer flippers.
Perfect. So my seal has short little flippers, both on the front and the back. My sea lion has long flippers on the front and on the back. What do they use these flippers for?
To swim,
that's
and
one thing. So my harbor seal is going to push himself through the water with these rear flippers. But my sea lion, he's going to pull himself through the water with these front flippers.
Yeah.
And then when they get on land, person number two, how does this seal move on land?
They like put their flippers on the legs and then they like
crawl. Yeah, they look kind of like a caterpillar moving along, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty slow.
What about the sea lion?
They just like jump instead of like crawling on it.
So they can actually walk on land because they rotate these hips here, and they can walk along on land. They can even climb big rocks and climb cliffs in order to get out of the water. So that's really cool. So there's something else that is very different about these animals. Person number two, can you tell me what it is?
Because they have a long, like the seal has a circular stomach, then the seals
do tend to be a little bit chubbier than what my sea lions do. However, one of our sea lions, Astro, is quite chubby.
He's like,
what are these things?
Ears.
So sea lions have ears just like us that stick out, right? Yeah. Here's his ears.
Just a little hole.
He has just that little hole. Very cool. So he doesn't need the ears that this guy has.
Isn't Astro about like 900 pounds?
He's a little over these animals, we call them vibrissa, and they do something really, really cool.
Hear with them.
They can. It's just like hearing. They sense things in the water.
Yeah,
they can sense temperature change.
It's kind of like they use their whiskers, like, to feel around.
They do. They use their whiskers to feel around.
Like
that vibrissa, just like a cat or
really
a caterpillar. Yep,
really
so
tiny.
They can locate their food that way, they can find each other that way, and they can find where they are as well. So, thinking back to our mammals, they're covered in fur.
Yes.
Okay. They have a backbone that goes down their back. They do have live birth, and they do nurse their young, and they are warm-blooded. Who can tell me what warm-blooded means, though?
That means ectothermic. They live outside.
So in order to be warm-blooded, what you have to do is your body temperature stays the same. We are warm-blooded. So our body temperature always stays the same, even if we go outside. The only way we can keep nice and warm and feel warm right now is to put a jacket on. Okay? But if I were cold-blooded and I went outside, the temperature around me is going to control my temperature. Okay?
Okay.
Very cool.
Yes.
So an interesting fact with seals and sea lions, we do not have any sea lions on our coastline. They are on the west coast. We do have seals here. And our stranding clinic is now open, which means that any of these little guys who have a hard time and are found on the beach, you can call Mystic Aquarium and report it, and we will send somebody out to help them. Do you two have anything else you'd like to say about seals and sea lions?
Actually, I have a cat at home.
Can we stay with our seals and sea lions? Do you have anything more you'd like to say about these? These right here?
Yeah.
Oh, that is where their vibrissa attach. So they have pores right along on their on their muscles. Okay? Well, I hope you enjoyed learning about seals and sea lions with us. Have a great day.